using Laplace transform of derivative theorem to solve the initial value problem y double prime plus 5 y prime plus 4 y equals 0, and you're given y of 0 equals 1, y prime of 0 equals negative 1. Following the theorem we have, so this is a second order differential equation. So we need to have s to the second times capital Y of s. So always start with s times the highest derivative times capital Y of s, and then subtract down to s to the 0. So minus s to the first times y of 0 minus s to the 0 times y prime of 0. Okay, so you subtract out to until you reach s to the 0. And so we have y capital Y of s, y of 0, and then y prime of 0. And the next term will be y double prime of 0 if you have a triple integral, triple derivative. Plus, so we have y prime, and don't forget to account for the leading coefficient here. Phi s to the first times capital Y of s, I'll start with s to the highest derivative, which is 1 in this case, times capital Y of s, okay? Then subtract down, minus phi y of 0. And here's a mistake that most students used to make. They forget to multiply by the phi here, the leading coefficient of this one. We just subtract y of 0. And it's minus in this case because y of 0 equals 1 is not equal to 0. So watch carefully what the steps you are doing. Plus 4 times y of 0 because you don't have any derivative here. And the Laplace transform of 0 is equal to 0. Now, take a look at y capital Y of s. Okay, so I'm going to factor out capital Y of s. Then in parentheses, I have s squared plus 5s plus 4 times capital Y of s. Now y of equals, I'm going to move everything else on the other side. Y of 0 is equal to 1. So you have negative s on this side, move it to the other side, which is positive s. Okay. Y prime of 0 is equal to negative 1. So negative y prime of 0 equals 1. Minus 5 times negative 1, which is 1. So you have 6. You have negative, it's a positive negative of negative 1, which is positive 1, minus negative 5 times 1, which is negative 5. So you have negative 4. Move to the other side, which is positive 4. Sorry guys, I just realized I have written down the problem incorrectly. So y prime of 0 is equal to 0. Okay. So we ignore this because it's just 0. So I still have s. And for this one, y 0 equals 1 negative 5 times 1 negative 5. Move to the other side, I have positive 5. Okay, so it should be good now. Now I'm going to divide by s squared plus 5s plus 4 on both sides to get capital Y of s itself. On this side, I have s plus 5 over s squared plus 5s plus 4. Okay, so we cannot find the error inverse of this, so we need to write it in factor forms, in a single fraction. So I'm going to keep everything on the top. Now at the bottom, I'm going to use the diamond method. So two numbers add up to 5, and their product is 4. So it's equal to 4 and 1. Okay, so we have s plus 4 times s plus 1. Right? Now, you are going to use partial fraction decomposition method to find the fractions of this. But it's long, and I believe most of you don't want to do that, right? So if I take a look closely at this, I see that I have s plus 4 and s plus 1 on the bottom, but on the top I have s plus 5. So it would be nice if I can eliminate one of these and simplify this. So the question is, can I do that? Well, you can if I do some magic. So let's do for s plus 4 because I like to have smaller number. I like to work with smaller number. So we have s plus 4, right? So I'm going to rectify as s plus 4 plus 1. You will see later why I do this. Okay? So s plus 4 plus 1, which is s plus 5. Okay? Everybody good here? Now I'm going to group this together. And because we have addition on top, so I'm going to break it down into two fractions, which is s plus 4 over s plus 4 times s plus 1 plus 1 over s plus 4 times s plus 1. Okay? For this one, cancel this out. then I left with 1 over s plus 1 on for this one, just rewrite it. Okay, so this is we are good for this one because we can find the inverse of this, but for this one we still have a problem because it's still in a product form. So we have to use partial fraction decomposition method again to find its fractions. So back in here, if I didn't use this method, I would go through a long process and I will get this. I would get this right, but just as you can see, just in a very few steps, I can get it right away. Now for this one, there's nothing we can do like we did for this one. So we have to fall back to partial fraction method. But here is another magic for you. Let's rewrite this first. And for this one, we are going to have something over s plus 4 plus something over s plus 1. So this can be obtained from the summation of this. Okay? Ignore this. So this can be obtained from summation of this. And I'm going to use a shortcut to find partial fraction decomposition here. So if you haven't had a chance to watch the video that I make about finding partial fractions in less than 30 seconds, I'll put a link in the upper right corner here so you can go there and check it out. So you can see they are off by 3. So I'm going to have 1/3 on the numerators. And the next step is to determine which one has a negative sign. So as I experienced, the bigger one will carry the negative sign. And now check it. So negative by crossing multiply. -1/3 times s plus 1/3 times s equals 0. -1/3 times 1, which is -1/3, plus 4/3, which is 3/3, which is 1. So we have 1. Okay, so this is good. Now take care of the rest of this. Of everything on both sides. On the left side, I have y of t, and on the right side, I have every inverse of 1 over s plus 1 is equal to e to the negative t, factor out -1/3. Every inverse of 1 over s plus 4 is equal to e to the negative 4t, factor out 1/3. And every inverse of 1 over s plus 1 is equal to e to the negative t. Okay? Now combine, you have e to the negative t. So simplify this by combining this and this, then you have 4/3 e to the negative t minus 1/3 e to the negative 4t. So this is your final answer. That's it. If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.